So, I woke up today and Tekken Bloodlines had dropped a new trailer. And it looked really, really cool. It's hard to convince people because I've never really done a lot of Tekken content on this channel. But I'm a huge Tekken fan. It is up there with one of my favorite game franchises of all time. Tekken has always had these little anecdotes that are very fun to look at. So, let me go through a few things from Tekken Bloodlines, which is actually Tekken 3, that not a lot of people probably know about. Paul has always been a very comedic character. So, seeing him have a spotlight in the Tekken Bloodlines series, whatever, might be kind of weird to some people. Well, this might be spoiler territory for Tekken Bloodlines because I don't know if they're going to use this or not. Continue at your own risk. In Tekken 3, Paul was always a huge player and super skilled. Matter of fact, he got to Ogre before Jin did, beat him, and then left because he thought he won the tournament, and then Jin showed up and beat True Ogre, which won him the tournament, which sent Paul in a depressive state of mind through Tekken 4. And then, you know, Tekken 5 Paul happened, which is an assassination of character, which is really sad because Paul was always super fun. There's a few other characters of note, one of them being Feng and Leroy being there, which is kind of odd, but now that I think about it for a second, Tekken 3 to Tekken 7 is like 2 years, so this actually makes sense. But yeah, Leroy was never in Tekken 3, Feng Wei was never in Tekken 3, and this iteration of Julia was not in Tekken 3, but considering how the timeline is now, it kind of fits. There's a lot of focus on King in this animation, which might be odd to some people, but let me tell you, King in Tekken 1 was second place, King in Tekken 2 was third, and King in Tekken 3 was dead. Yeah, no, this King and this King are not the same person. Matter of fact, the original King died because Ogre killed him. R.I.P.
Unfortunately, the orphanage is running out of money and King has turned to heavy drinking.
And then one of the kids from the orphanage the original King was donating money to was also Omega drunk, and then Armor King took him in and made him into a wrestler. Anyway, he's super cool, man. Don't take your eyes off King. If you want to talk about Ogre, there's not a lot to talk about, which is really sad because I love Ogre's design and I love, like, anything poured into Ogre. I love him. He is huge. He is gigantic. He punch people. He nice. Look at him. He green. The Tekken Tag 2 ending says that he's some sort of interdimensional being who will end the world, and also there's many of him, and this ending is genuinely terrifying. If you know anything about Tekken 2, you know that Nina Williams was in Tekken 2. And Tekken 2 to Tekken 3 is like 20 years. So, why the hell does Nina look like this? Well, let me tell you. Nina was put in cryogenic sleep and used for experiments, which also led to this guy happening and killing the entirety of the Tekken 5 cast. So, when Tekken 3 happened, she got out of cryogenic sleep and looks like she's still in her, what, 27 or something? And apart from that, that's all I can really talk about. Keep your eyes on Hwarang as well. He's a really cool character. Xiaoyu doesn't exactly look like that in Tekken 3, but we can let it pass. And honestly, I'm very excited for this. I am so sold on Tekken Bloodline.